Forever, one of my favorites. On ESPN.com, Tim McMahon wrote on the unwritten rules of modern-day trash talk, including not getting personal or talking when you're on the bench. Austin Rivers. Paul, you tend to be pretty good at this whole talking trash thing. What was your primary tactic?
You know, I always tried to always talk about the player's weaknesses. Like, you know, I couldn't really talk too much to Tracy. He had everything in a package. When a guy couldn't shoot, I would lay off of
him.
Tell him to shoot. Right here, I'm telling Al, like, look here, man. Look here. You cannot guard me.
This is one of the best
right here,
though.
You might as well go sit down and take this. And there's nothing you can do about it.
I got your back, you cheddar cheese.
It was probably a little more censored than, you know, I can't really say what I said then.
Sure, sure.
But, you know, that was the trash talk era. You know, the Kevin Garnetts, myself, you know, guys like Gary Payton. You know, just that era of the late 90s and 80s and the early 2000s.
What's off limits?
It just ended now.
No, what are the rules? Like, no moms?
No personal.
You can't talk about nobody, mom, nobody
kids. I remember telling Dwight Howard it looked like he had some Ronald McDonald shoes on. And he did. He had a pair of yellow and red clown shoes on at the free throw line, and everybody started laughing.
I got into it with a guy on the court one time, and I told him, I pointed at the bench. I say, look at your bench. Look at your teammates. And he was like, what you talking about? I say, they're wearing T-Max on their feet.
I say
your teammate got T-Max on, man.
Oh, man.
That kind of hurts.
I'm rolling with the fellas. As long as you keep it basketball, yeah, you talk about somebody's weaknesses.
Can I ask a stupid question, though?
Of course.
If the whole point of trash talking is to get under one skin, why do we have these arbitrary rules about no moms, no significant others? Why not just have everything be on the table?
Well, that sounds good in theory, but you really don't go there because there is a level of respect you have for your peers that play on this level. But at the same time, you just talk about players' weaknesses. And here's when you do it, when their teammates can hear it. So a guy that can't shoot, you leave them open like Paul said and be like, he with us.
Right.
No, hey, Jay.
Let me tell you what
we used to say about that, Jay. When somebody couldn't shoot and he shoots the ball, start the break, man. Start the break.
Let me tell you, the best time to talk trash is when you're at the free throw line. Everybody's quiet.
Yeah.
You say something, the microphone's under the TV. That's a good time. That's a good time to talk.
Are there any great guys doing it right now?
It's kind of a lost art. I mean, it's really a lost art.
Everybody are buddies these days. AAU
basketball. Oh, you know what? I forgot. There's Twitter wars. There's Instagram wars.
Embiid is great.
Yeah.
You don't really get the up close and personal effect of the trash talk these days. It's all done after the game or before the game.
Now players are yelling at the officials.
Yeah, that's not right.
It's just not the same. You don't get that.
That'd test to see if you're a real hooper. Because somebody talking trash to you and they getting buckets, let's see if you could come back at them.
You know, everybody's friends.
I know, we hate friends, don't we, Paul?
Have it in your chest, baby. Have it in your chest.
Wizards.